Very good morning, students. Okay, in last few introductory lectures onto the histology, I have told you about the basic things, okay, which are not given in the most of the books. Okay, just that will help you to understand the histology. Okay, now from today we are going to the actual histology classes. Okay, are the videos which I will be just uploading, they will be dealing with the actual histological classes. Okay, now let us begin with the basic tissues of body. Now in our introductory lecture I have told you that our body consists of the four basic tissues. There are four basic tissues, and these basic tissues, they are called as epithelial tissue, then the connective tissue. And this connective tissue will include also the cartilage and bones, which are the specialized connective tissue. Beside the connective tissue, okay, proper, which consists of the loose connective tissue and the dense connective tissue, which we'll learn in great detail when I will teach you the connective tissue. The third basic tissue of the body is the muscular tissue. This muscular tissue, as I told you in the introductory lecture also, consists of the three different kind of the muscle: the smooth muscle, the cardiac muscle, and the skeletal muscle. The skeletal muscle is predominantly present in our body. The fourth basic tissue is that of the nervous tissue, which consists of the nerve cells and nerve fibers, okay, nerve cells, including the peripheral nerves, the spinal cord, and the part of the, I mean to say, brain, that means central nervous system, and the peripheral nervous system is made up of the nervous tissue. So these are the four basic tissues of the body, and I must have told you in the introductory lecture that these four basic tissues of the body are responsible for formation of any part of the human body, any organ of the human body, or any system of the human body. There is no fifth basic tissue in our body. Okay, I must have given an example of the organ, say for the intestine, and all these four basic tissues are present in the section of the intestine, whether it is a longitudinal section or it is a transverse section. So now by this time you know very well that there are the four basic tissue in our body, and few videos will be dealing with these basic tissues of the body. Okay, first we will deal with the epithelium. Today's video is just an introductory lecture on to that of the epithelium, and from the next video I will take the epithelium proper in little detail. Okay, in detail. So let's define the first basic tissue which we have seen is the epithelium. This is epithelium. And what is the definition of epithelium? Let us see, and where this epithelium tissue is found in our body. Now this epithelium is a continuous layer of made up of the same continuous cells which are arranged in single layer or multiple layers. Say for example, this is the cells, and this cells, if I draw the nucleus here, just let me draw it only with this color. Okay, this is the continuous sheet of the cells, which is a single layer cell, but the epithelium can also be the multiple layer, that means layers are arranged one upon the others. And this kind of cells which are arranged either in single layer or in multiple layer onto the basement membrane, and they cover the surface of the body, various surfaces of our body. Now this epithelial layer which is covering to the various surfaces of our body, surfaces, when I say the surfaces of our body, it may be a external surface, say for example the stratified squamous epithelium of our skin is covering to the outer surface of our body, say the cornea, the conjunctiva, the lip epithelium, the tongue, the mouth epithelium, anything on the external surface of the body is covered by the epithelium. So this epithelial layer or the seat of the cell, whether single or multiple, is covering to the external surface of our body. Then this single or multiple layer, not only it is covering to our external surface, say far as I gave you an example of the skin, but it is also covering to the lumen of the visceral. When I say the lumen of the visceral, for example, if you draw a cross section of the blood vessels, whether it is artery or vein, then the internal structure or lumen of the blood vessel is also covered by the layer of epithelium, and this epithelium, which is lining to the inner aspect of the lumen of the blood vessel, though it is called as endothelium here, okay, we don't bother about this name endothelium, but this is covering the inner aspect, because the rest of the area, as you will learn later in the blood vessel, is different, other tissues are present. So this is an inner lining of the organ or the viscera. Here it is blood vessel. Similarly, if you take any other structure, say for example the intestine itself, if you will see, then this intestine is also on its internal lumen of the intestine, which may show the presence of the villi or projection finger line. This is also covered by the epithelium. So this is epithelium covering to the internal lumen of the organ or that of the blood vessels or the duct or any of the tube which is present here inside the body. This covering is here, that is of the epithelial tissue. So it is either outer surface or it is that of the inner surface. But then this epithelium in our body is also covering to that of the cavities, okay, body cavities. When I say the body cavities, you should know that there are large cavities in our body. These cavities, for example, very unusual example which is given is the cavity surrounding to the heart, which is called as the pericardial cavity. The cavity surrounding to that of the lung, which is called as the pleural cavity, and cavity of the abdomen, which is called as peritoneum. There are many other cavities, but these are the large cavities in the thorax and abdomen, and their free surface of these cavities are also covered by the epithelium. Let us see the lung. A very rough diagram of the lung I have drawn here. See this, and this is covered by the epithelium, and this epithelium, which covers onto the outer surface of the lung, this epithelium is the visceral epithelium. Then same become continuous onto the periphery, and it continues to that of the other structures of the body. Thus it forms a closed cavity, what is called as the pleural cavity, and on its surface it is also lined by the cells, and these cells, they are onto the visceral surface or into the parietal surface of this cavity. So these are the epithelium which are covering, and in between these two epithelial layer there is the pleural cavity. So what I want to say you is that there is no place in our body, whether external surface, internal surface, or the lumen of the viscera or the cavity, which is not covered by the epithelium. It may be a single layer epithelium or it may be a multiple layer epithelium. They all are covered by the epithelium. So epithelium is thus a continuous seat of the cell, which is covering to this outer or the inner surfaces of our body. That will be the definition. Okay, that will be the definition of the epithelium. Let us see the same seat or that is which forms the epithelium. This surfaces of the epithelium cell, say for example, if I take a epithelial, this is the columnar epithelium for example, with the tall columnar cell, and they contain the nuclei. And nuclei, by this time you must be knowing that a columnar epithelium is identified with the help of the elongated nucleus, which are arranged at right angle to that of the basement membrane, to the basement membrane. So these columnar cells, okay, this will form a columnar epithelium. Now, this forms the free surface of the epithelium. This surface is the free, which is just lining through the separate intestine. It is inside the intestine, again the same diagram, where villi are there. And very rough diagram, very quickly I will write here, these are the villi, and these villi are lined by the safarin intestine, it is lined by the columnar cells. This is the columnar epithelium is here, and this is the cavity of the intestine or the lumen of the gut or the intestine. So this is the, one of the surface will be this, that is the free surface. Then this free surface in most of the epithelium are as such, but at certain places, depending on its function, this free surface of epithelium may show the further foldings, either a very small or, not very tall foldings. This will be called as the striated borders or microvilli to increase the surface area. Sometimes this foldings may be large, and these large foldings will have different purpose, and they are will be called as the cilia. So this apical surface or the outer surface or the free surface of the cell may show the various modification depending on its function, which I am going to tell you in great detail in the subsequent videos. Okay. Then you will have in the seat of the epithelial cell layer, say for instance, this was one of the cell, columnar cell, this is another columnar cell. This was the apical or the free surface of the cell. The other surface will be called as the lateral surface. And lateral surface all around this, they are in opposition with each other. The cells, they are forming the junctional or the junctional complex, which you must have read. It may be desmosome, it may be tight junctions, junular adherence or the gap junctions, various kind of the junctions by which one cell is attached to the other. And not only in this section, you imagine it into the three dimensions, okay, and all around the cells they are attached to one another, okay, they are, so nothing can pass between the two cells, okay, nothing. So this will be the lateral surface. So there is an apical surface or free surface, then lateral surface, and then one of the surface which is here, which is attached here. Now the cells are attached at the bottom, okay, or the basal surface with this membrane which is called as the basal lamina, and sometimes it is also called as basement membrane. Okay, when I will teach you the basal lamina or basement membrane, I will tell you in great detail about its structure. At present, you just remember that the epithelial cell have a free surface, epithelial cell have a lateral surface which are attached to the neighboring cell which is forming the seat or the layer of the epithelium. Okay, and covering to the free or the internal surface, and then these cells, they are attached the basement membrane, their basal surface is attached. But in case of the multiple layer cells, this was an example of the simple epithelium, but if you will see the multiple cells, which is called as the squamous cell, you will see these cells, only the bottom cells, they are arranged at the basement membrane. The other cells, they are arranged or we say attached on their lateral surface or apical surface with the neighboring cell, by again the same junctional complexes. Okay, they are again, don't think that they are floating or they are just not continuous and it's not connected with the neighboring cell. They are also connected with the space-like junctional complexes with each other, even in the multiple layer of the epithelium, where it is in multiple layer. Okay, so I have told you about what is the definition of the epithelium. I have told you about where you will get the epithelium, either on free surface of body, in the lumen of the viscera, or in the body cavities. Then I have told you the three different surfaces which are forming the epithelium, or the surfaces of cell which are forming the epithelium: a free surface, a lateral surface, and a basal surface of the cell. Okay, basal surface of the cell. And another important general thing which I want to tell you, that whether the epithelium is simple single layer sheet of the cell, or it, even if it is calling on stratified cell layer, this epithelium, they are avascular. Avascular, what does it mean? Avascular means where it is not supplied by the blood vessel. So this epithelium, they are divide of the blood vessel, they are not supplied. Then how it gets its nutrition? It gets its nutrition from the connective tissue which is present deep to that of the basement membrane. See, this was the basement membrane, and deep to this, this will be, say, for example, the connective tissue which is full of the blood vessels, and the capillaries which are present here deep to this basement membrane, they will send the oxygen and the nutrition through the basement membrane to the cells. But blood vessel itself will not go into the epithelium because they are avascular in nature. But at the same time, if it is not the blood vessel, but the nerves may go inside, okay, inside the cells, because they have to supply the sensory innervation to the epithelium, because one of the important function of the epithelium, which is lining to the surface, is the sensation. Okay, they just conduct the sensation. Say, for example, our skin is highly sensitive for pain, touch, and temperature. Okay, so the epithelium, anywhere they are sensitive inside lumen or outside the surfaces. So though they are avascular, but they are having the nerve supply. That you should always keep in your mind. Okay, after this we come to the classification of the epithelium. Let us come to the classification of epithelium, which you must